Hello guys, today we will learn about Brayton cycle, which is the portion in your module 6. So module 6 basically deals with different types of power cycles. One of such cycle is Brayton cycle. Okay, so Brayton cycle is also known as a constant pressure cycle or a Joule cycle, constant pressure cycle or a Joule cycle. So the application of this Brayton cycle is in gas turbines. Okay, so you all know about, hope you all know about gas turbines. They are of two types basically. That is, first one is the open cycle gas turbine and the second one is the closed cycle gas turbine. In a closed cycle gas turbine, we have four different components. That is, the first one is the compressor, combustion chamber, turbine and a pre-cooler. Okay, so these four constitute the main parts of a closed cycle gas turbine. Now let's move on to draw a schematic diagram for a closed cycle gas turbine. So first one is the compressor. I have drawn a compressor here. Okay, so compressor here. So basically, you know that in a gas turbine, the working fluid is gas. So before entering into the compressor, let the gas be at state 1, and after compression, let it be at state 2. So process 1 to 2 is basically, in a Brayton cycle, is basically it's an isentropic compression. Isentropic compression means the compression takes place at constant entropy. Isentropic compression, process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. Okay. And after compression, the gas moves on to the combustion chamber, where the fuel is also added for the combustion process. So basically, it's a heat addition process, right? So process 2 to 3, as the fuel is added and the combustion process going on, so it will be a heat addition process, and also this heat addition will be at constant pressure, or it will be an isobaric process. So altogether, we can say the process 2 to 3, fuel addition, combustion, altogether is an isobaric heat addition process. Okay, so that's all about process 2 to 3. And moving on to next process, that is process 3 to 4. You know that in between you have a turbine. So what happens in a turbine? The gas gets expanded and we will get the required work output in a turbine. So process 3 to 4 is basically, it will be an expansion process, and also it will be taking place at constant entropy. So process 3 to 4 is an isentropic expansion process. Process 3 to 4, you have a turbine, in between you have a turbine, and the gas gets expanded, and you will get the required work output in this process, that is process 3 to 4. So process 3 to 4 is basically an expansion process, and also it takes place at constant entropy, so it will be an isentropic expansion process, that is process 3 to 4. Now moving on to the final process, that is 4 to 1, you have a pre-cooler. So as the name suggests, the gas that is coming out from the turbine will move on to the pre-cooler, and the air gets cooled in the pre-cooler, and so it will be a heat rejection process in the pre-cooler, because the temperature of the air is getting down. Okay, so it will be basically a heat rejection process, and also it is taking place at constant pressure. So it will be again isobaric heat rejection process for the process 4 to 1. Isobaric heat rejection process for the process 4 to 1. Okay, so now we will move on to draw the PV and the TS diagram for a Brayton cycle. Okay, so we have already defined the process, different four process for the Brayton cycle, and now we will be drawing the PV and the TS diagram. So the first process in a Brayton cycle is isentropic compression. So let's see how it goes in a PV diagram. So process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. As you can see, 1 to 2 I had drawn here a compression process. Okay, so in a compression process, the pressure always increases. So 1 to 2, the pressure is increasing. And moving on to the TS diagram, the compression process also is done with constant entropy, that is isentropic process. So process 1 to 2 is isentropic process. So this is x-axis entropy axis. So 1 to 2 is a constant entropy process. And process 2 to 3 is isobaric heat addition. So isobaric means a constant pressure heat addition. So I have drawn a constant pressure line here. Process 2 to 3 is a constant pressure line. And moving on to the TS diagram, process 2 to 3 is this line. Okay, so you can see that the temperature increases. So as a heat addition, the temperature is increasing. And 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion. So in an expansion, volume will be increasing and pressure will be decreasing. You know that. So I have drawn an isentropic expansion process here, process 3 to 4. Pressure is reducing and volume is increasing. Similarly, in the TS diagram, it is isentropic expansion. So it will be at constant entropy. It will be at constant entropy. And the last process, that is the heat rejection process, it is also taking place at constant pressure, similar to process 2 to 3. 4 to 1 is also an isobaric process, that is a constant pressure process. So I have drawn a line 4 to 1 here for a constant pressure process, and in the TS diagram, 4 to 1 line is this as the temperature is getting reduced as the heat is rejected. Okay, so that's all about PV and the TS diagram for a Brayton cycle. Okay, so now we will move on to derive the expression for efficiency of a Brayton cycle. So the air standard efficiency, air standard efficiency of a Brayton cycle can be defined as, we know that the efficiency is basically the desired work output, that is the work done, desired output, that is the work done divided by heat supplied, right? So work done divided by heat supplied, that is the output by input. We have desired output by input, that is the work done divided by heat supplied. Okay, so what is the work done? It is the heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by, again, heat supplied, right? Okay, fine. So what is heat supplied in a Brayton cycle, or in which process we are supplying heat? As we said earlier, we are supplying heat during the process 2 to 3, and 2 to 3 process isobaric heat addition process. So constant pressure process is basically 2 to 3. So 2 to 3 is basically a constant pressure process. So what is heat supplied in a constant pressure process? It is mcp into T3 minus T2. So you have done this derivation in when you are studying the different thermodynamic processes. So heat supplied in a constant pressure process is mcp into T3 minus T2 and minus heat rejected. So heat rejection takes place basically for the process 4 to 1. So 4 to 1 is again which process? It's again a constant pressure process, right? So again it will become, so again a constant pressure process, so it will be mcp into process 4 to 1, so it will be T4 minus T1, larger volume minus smaller volume. The temperature, higher temperature minus lower temperature, that is T4 minus T1, divided by heat supplied again, mcp into T3 minus T2, right? Okay, so taking mcp common from numerator and the denominator, we will get T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2. Okay, so mcp getting cancelled here, and now in this step we are taking T3 minus T2 common, so it will be 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2, right? So this is one one expression for the efficiency of Brayton cycle, 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2. Okay. So, now moving on to further process, there is, now consider the process, consider process 1 to 2, so which is a process, isentropic compression process, right? So, isentropic compression process, so what is the PVT relationship there? What's the PVT relationship there? So, isentropic process is basically an reversible adiabatic process, right? So, we can write, so for a adiabatic process, the PVT relationship is PV raised to gamma is a constant, right? PV raised to gamma is a constant. And we have other relations connecting pressure and temperature, pressure and volume, temperature and volume, right? So, you have studied this expression in your previous classes while we are dealing with the thermodynamic process. So, just turn back and look for this expression, that is T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 whole raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, these are derived from these two expressions, that PV raised to gamma is a constant and PV by T is a constant. These are derived from, these all expressions are derived from these two expressions. So, just turn back your notebook and see. So, you will find this expression T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, what will be T2 here? So, T2 will be T1 into RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. I am calling P2 by P1 is equal to RP, that is the pressure ratio. Pressure ratio, now we are expressing this as we are expressing this in terms of pressure. So P2 by P1 I am representing it as P2 by P1 I am representing as RP, which is the pressure ratio. Okay. So this is the pressure ratio, I am calling it as equation 1. Okay, fine. Now again for the process process 3 to 4, also for the process T 3 to 4, it's again, which process 3 to 4 is again isentropic process, isentropic expansion process, that is basically a reversible adiabatic process, right? So again I can write for the process I can write T3 by T4 equals P2 by P1, or you can write P3 by P4 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay, P3 by P4 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, now check again the PV diagram. So, you know that P3 is equal to P2 as well as P4 is equal to P1, right? P3 is equal to P2 and P4 is equal to P1. So, I can write P3 is equal to P2 and P4 equals P1, right? So, we can write T3 by T4 equals P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, that's equal to RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma, because I have already defined here, that is P2 by P1 is RP. P2 by P1 is RP, that is the pressure ratio. So, I am again getting P2 by P1, which is the pressure ratio, that is RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma, that is T3 by T4 is equal to gamma minus 1 by T3 by T4 is equal to RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma, calling it as equation 2. Okay, or I can write T3 is equal to T4 into RP raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma, and this I am calling it as equation 2. Okay, fine. So, we got the, from 1 and 2, we got the expression for T2 as well as T3, right? T2 as well as T3. So now again moving on to the air standard efficiency expression, that is we got this as 1 minus, earlier we got this as 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2, right? So now we have got the expression for T3 as well as T2, right? So I am from 1 and 2 I am substituting for T3 and T2. Okay, so 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by, so what is T3? That is T4. T3 is T4 into Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So I am writing that down here. T4 into Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma minus, what is T2? It is T1 into Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. Right? So we got this expression 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T4 into Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma minus T1 into Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma, right? So now I am taking this Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma as a common factor from this denominator. So we will get T4 minus T1, 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma into T4 minus T1. Am I correct? So I can cancel this T4 minus T1 from numerator and the denominator, right? So it will become 1 minus 1 by Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay. So this is the expression for efficiency of air standard efficiency of a Brayton cycle. That is 1 minus 1 by Rp raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. So it depends. So the efficiency of a Brayton cycle depends mainly on this pressure ratio, that is P2 by P1. Depends only on the, mainly on the pressure ratio Rp. Okay. So that's all about the efficiency of a Brayton cycle.